Today, you've heard the best and brightest of Forsyth County Republican Party. You've heard many of our candidates, many of our elected officials. We do have two that we're going to highlight, though. It's the Commissioner District 3 race. Todd Levent is our commissioner. David Hole's the challenger. We're going to let David stand up and speak and come on up. Okay.
Good morning. My name is David Hall, and I'm running for commissioner in District 3. First of all, I'd like to thank all y'all for coming out this morning. And thank you, Brad and GOP, for inviting me to be here to speak and let people get to know me a little bit better. I am a newcomer to politics. Also, I'd like to thank my lovely wife of 25 years, Kim, she's here, and my son, DJ, for getting up early and coming out and helping me get started. They're not used to doing things this early morning, but I greatly appreciate it. And for almost 22 years, I've had the great pleasure of not just calling Forsyth County my home, but I've had District 3 has been my home for the last 22 years. You know, my wife and I have been lucky enough to have raised our kids in District 3 and had the great privilege of sending them to the great school system that we have in Forsyth County. They attended all three levels of school, starting out at Midway Elementary, and then graduated from there to Victor Creek Elementary, and then the middle school, and then on to the West Forsyth High School. I can't say enough about our school system. I think it's one of the best in the state. And not only did I get to enjoy the great school system, but the parks and recs that we have in Forsyth County are awesome. We grew up, as probably many of y'all did, we lived at the ballpark. We lived at Midway Ballpark. I coached baseball, football, softball. I didn't coach the cheerleading. Kim left that to Kim, but I coached there for 18 years and loved it. Got to meet a lot of great people and really looked forward to it. My God and family are the two most important things in my life. Kim and I, our family, has for many years attended the Browns Bridge Church. We love worshiping there. That's probably enough about me. I'll get on about my campaign. My campaign is not focused on a burning desire for another title. The titles that drive my choices are the titles I've already earned. I've earned the title of a family man. I've earned the title of a small business owner, successful business owner for 25 years. And also, I earned the title of a servant leader. My campaign is focused on ensuring that not just my kids, but my grandkids and our future generations are given the same opportunity that Kim and I were given when we moved in Forsyth County nearly 22 years ago. You know, 22 years is a long period of time, and during that time, we had the unique opportunity to witness a lot of changes in Forsyth County, in District 3. We also had to experience an incredible amount of growth in our district. And then there, with that growth, we had some growth was good and some growth was bad. I'm going to be working on, your commissioner, on the good growth. With all the growth that comes into our area, we're faced with some numerous challenges, but we're also faced with numerous opportunities as well. The hardworking families of Forsyth County deserve a commissioner who, one, will manage the growth, two, effectively, that's the key word, effectively work with all the others in our county, and also ensure that taxpayers have a voice in their local government, because government does belong to the people. And by that, what I mean is that, you know, as I have already received several phone calls from people, and I've asked to meet with people. I look forward to that. I'm working with the citizens. I take their phone calls and meet with them anytime I can. I listen to their concerns, answer the questions if I can, and give them my opinion if I'm asked. I can tell you one thing I will not do. If I am asked a question, I will not tell John what he wants to hear to answer his question. But that same question that Joe asked me, I'm not going to tell him what he wants to hear. Okay? I'm a straight shooter. I'm a man of integrity. I work with everybody, and I'm passionate about that. I'll be an unwavering advocate for the homeowners of Forsyth County. I'm also working to grow a local economy, and also hold our elected county officials accountable. I understand that the greatness in our communities comes from the citizens. It does not come from elected officials at all. My experience does not count in politics. I told you, this is my first political race. I'm learning as I go, but experience does come in the form of three things. One, as I said earlier, a small business, a successful business person for 25 years, creating private sector jobs, and also volunteering in our community. I think that's really important to get involved, as I am doing. My service on the Board of Commissioners is not a path to another office, I'll tell you that. I'm just doing my duty. Matter of fact, I'll take it a step further. I'll pledge no more than two terms in office. I also have several other pledges I'd like to make. One being to help the local economy to stay strong and vibrant in our district. We also pledge to hold government accountable. Also pledge to eliminate unnecessary spending. Pledge to help the transportation problems that plague our county. We all know, all driving through Forsyth, it's really tough in some areas, especially the south end of the county. And lastly, I pledge to work closely with the law enforcement officials and the public safety officials in our county to guarantee the continued safety of the citizens of Forsyth County. You know, we're blessed to live in an awesome county. Forsyth County has so many things to offer. Lakeland here, for example, it's an enormous economic engine. It's a tremendous natural resource to our county. We also have the awesome shopping facilities, the fantastic restaurants, the great schools, as I said, and parks and rec. We also have the awesome hospital. We have the Greenway. What a tremendous asset to the county there. I don't use it, but my wife sure does enjoy it. She goes on it every day. It's a great asset to our community. To me, Forsyth County is not just a dot on a map or just a blip on the radar. But to me, Forsyth County is my passion, it's my community, and it's a place I love to call home. And I'd just like to thank y'all so much for listening to me this morning, and hope y'all have a good rest of your weekend. Thank you very much.
Our next speaker of the day is Todd Levent. Come on up, Commissioner.
All right, so I've captured my first cold of the season. I've beat it all year till now. Yeah, timing's great. Anyways, y'all know who I am. I'm Todd Levent. I am Commissioner of the 3rd District. Originally, when I stepped up to do the job, it was based on nobody knocking on my door and asking me to because they wanted me to do it. I was just watching all the facts and all the things that were going on in the county. It was the downturn of the economy, and I had some free time. As I read some of the paperwork in 2009, our budget and the reserve account went from $40 million down to about $13 million. It was concerning to me. It made me dig a little more for facts. I'm not one that likes to listen to folks that say, hey, guess what's going on? I like to dig for the facts, see the real paper, make my decisions on that. As I got into a little bit deeper, I saw some land purchasing stuff that were really concerning to me. One, I'm not getting the details of it, but it sold to the county for $7.2 million. And today, the research we see wouldn't net us $1.5 million for the same piece of land. These are the kind of wasteful spending things that got me really, really interested in running. Try to put a stop to, although I'm only one vote, I'm not so arrogant to think I could do it by myself. More so, I've been here for 23 years with my family, and I've got to tell you, as I lived in Sandy Springs area and I watched Highway 400 get built, and I saw the environment we grew up in Sandy Springs, and the growth was coming, I saw Forsyth County as a great place to raise a family, and that was my goal, and that's where we ended up. And it's true, and it's shown to be very true today. So some of the reasons why I'm trying to run again are quite simply because to help secure government transparency, as you've seen in the past, I voted for it. And I believe strongly in the freedom of open records. It helps keep government honest. To continue the quality of life that we've all come to love in this great community of ours. And I know this seems redundant, but it's a fact. This will require reasonable and well thought out growth and architecture. If you've noticed, I got through in my first year, the first overlay in our district, besides the one that was on Castleberry. It goes down all the major arteries and requires a minimum standard architecture, four board fencing, additional plantings. All of this in hopes that we have a little more continuity. If you ever drive on Highway 9, you go, what is going on here with the thought and the process of the future development? So hopefully over the next years, we'll see that change and start to turn into something much nicer, much prettier, and help raise property values around us, which helps all of us, because it also, without raising millage, gets more tax into the general fund and keeps us from ever having to raise taxes on the millage rate. I want you, everybody knows that they've watched the latest reports from the Labor Department. Forsyth County now is at a 5% unemployment rate and it's still going down. So we've had tremendous success in jobs coming into the county. Businesses from coming from all over the state, the country, and even abroad, and overseas have come here to run some of their headquarters. I've worked with the chamber on these. I've met with these people as they come in to show interest. I greet them as well as I can, give them as much comfort level as I can to bring them here. Although I don't have that much power to do, the chamber's doing a phenomenal job on their own. Anybody would like to see some of my accomplishments, I'm simply going to bore you to death. They are on my website, toddlevent.commissioner.com. Some of the main reasons why I believe that I need to stay in office one more term is because once you start your first term, you get a lot of things in play, as I just described the overlay. There's other things that I believe in strongly in not wasting our money on certain roads and doing the roads that need to be done first and take them in order of priority. I completely agree with the comments earlier that our gas taxes that are collected that go to the federal government, they come back to the state, and then are split congressionally throughout the state is done not by proportionate of the money that's collected, which is a very problematic. Maybe when you're in a community growing as fast as us and we're collecting so much more money than some other communities, we should get back our fair share. It's very problematic when that then puts on the taxpayer, local taxpayers back through SPLOST and consideration of other bonds because we're not getting our fair share back. It almost seems as if we're paying twice. Once with the gas tax and once with an additional bonding. I'm not trying to be bashing anybody, just saying you just should get back the fair amount of taxes that you put in the system. Otherwise, you are then giving your tax money to other communities who have taxation without representation. To go down the line a little bit more, those of you don't know, and you probably do know, any one of these jobs takes a lot more time than you think it does. And I have to thank my family for all the sacrifices they have made. 30, 40 hours a week, sometimes more. I put my children to bed so they can night. I'm up a lot of times at 1, 2 in the morning. If you've ever received an email from me, you'll see the date stamp and time, how late it is at night. And it's just what happens. Some weeks you might get 100 emails. Some weeks you get 500 emails. And it's interesting, I have to tell you the least. Although I love every bit of it, I love everything I've been involved in to date. All the classes that we were able to take through the ACCG, through the Georgia University, it gives us government classes, government law classes to keep you up to date on how and why you vote certain ways and why you have to vote these certain ways. It's awesome that it's available to take. I took them as quick as I could, went through them as quick as I could, just to make sure that the votes I make don't put the county in any liability. But I also got to tell you, we have one of the best darn county attorneys ever. He actually is one of the two that teach in all of these classes, and we're very fortunate to have him, Ken Gerard. Touching back on some more things, if you all have seen some of these zonings that are coming to fruition now, popping up all over the place and building houses everywhere, almost all of those that are putting cars on the road today were zoned from the year 2000 through 2009. The ones that are coming forward today, I have not voted on a single one as it was submitted. Every single one I've been worked with the developers and lowered the density. I'm trying to make more sense than increase the lot size, increase the house size. My biggest one that I got involved in, and I can't do it on my own, obviously, the landowner has the rights. they have to give that right to anybody that can develop it, and then they come to us and ask what works here. Was the Venable property. It turned into what they now call the Traditions, and it's run by Front Door Properties. They came to us, and came to me and said, we don't believe in this economy that's now turning around, that the what was originally zoned with over 1.1 million square feet of commercial, which included up to 3-4-story buildings, is gonna work. You've only got 2-lane roads around there, and 900 homes with almost 400 plus townhomes in that community. I agreed with them totally. That was one of the reasons why I ran. There was no plan for any roads to get widened around there anytime soon, and it would have been 2 times the traffic that the avenues produces, and surrounded by 2-lane roads, it would have been a disaster for everybody that lived there. Fortunately, they worked with us, and we now have 182,000 square feet of village shopping, and we are down to a little over 500 homes, and down to less than 100 townhomes. That's where I've been involved in getting involved in all of the zonings that makes sense for the community. We don't know exactly what the number is. There's a lot of dispute whether a home at 280,000 or 350,000, the exact number that finds a neutral tax collection for the level of services that we provide. But somewhere in there is probably the magic number, and that's not counting the money that comes back to the schools from the state to federal government. Anyways, I don't want to keep going too much and bore you too much. I will continue to work with the state and meet with them on a regular basis, as all commissioners do. We've been doing it 2-3 times a year in hopes that they're able to find the money to help us with our state roads. Our county roads should not be the primary roads. The state roads should be the primary roads, and we should not widen our back roads into 4- and 5-lane roads before they do theirs first. It's not fair to do that to the residents in the area. Thank you.